Thank you, Vijay. Thank you. God bless you. You are always lovable to me, and good afternoon to everybody. And it is unlucky that every time I am receiving lectures and presentation, that is after lunch, so people start napping. So I'll not allow to lap. We'll have a concept in the field of a forensic science, which I love. This is my field, which is called documents. Friends, shall I give my little bit background that I worked in Central Forensic Science Laboratory? I'm proud of that. I worked in that lab, which housed all the branches of the forensic sciences. The way it was started in 1968, and the way it was scattered services to the forensics. And I'm thankful to Dr. Bami and Dr. Sehgal, who mushroomed up my career in the field of a document examination. Although it is a very small topic, called friends, documents, very small topic, but it has an impact of, say, huge in the society. I say like that once, so I'll not present any paper, I'll not show anything, I'll just have interaction with you. See, I'll touch the gray areas also. Once we are talking of, say, this document, and I said that it is a very small topic, which is called documents. Any country and every country, when they grow with the growth of 6% more, they are bound to have this white collar crisis. Friends, I'm lucky that I joined this lab. And there were few cases of the documents received in 1980s. Now it was told that around thousands of cases were started pending in this because of the same growth which we are going in the 6% more. As far as mentors are concerned, friends, this is called CBI, wherein I worked my day in, day out. Say, there are six zones, basically, anti-corruption, banking, all these things. Say, 70 to 80% of the cases which you receive for document forensic examination that pertains to documents. So the stake in CBI and other branches are very high of document science. I said that this is a very small topic, which is called document, but it is having a huge impact in the society. On the lighter note, friends, I'll say that there was a murder of called Vidya Jain case in 1972. Vidya Jain was raped and murdered. Vidya Jain was murdered. Vidya Jain was basically the wife of a Dr. Jain. He was happened to be the doctor of President of India at that time. It was in 4th December, I think, in 1972. So he was murdered by two goons hired by Dr. Jain. They were called Kardar Singh and Ujagar Singh. They were given 25,000 rupees to kill that lady. So after 5 years, one was caught, lifer, and another was caught on this. He was hanged. He was sentenced only for meager 25,000 rupees. Only for meager. After 12 years of that, there was a scam called Harshad Mehta scam. 188 crore rupees was released. So the thing, the crime, the conviction of crimes, the rate of all amount is more. Then there was a case which is called Taj Corridor case. 275 crore was released. Then there was a case which is called Barupula scam, Hossain scam. So many scams, your 2G scam, your coal scam, that runs into billions of millions of dollars. So the stake of country's economy was very high once you are having this type of crimes. And I feel proud and relaxed, friends, apart from doing so many cases, not even a single case. Ultimately, the test of the experts lies in the court of law. Not even a single case till date was disputed by any court, although I had spent 38 years of service in the science laboratory and after 2 years at retirement. Friends, I said that basically we'll touch the topic which is having a gray areas, and that should give the relevance in the court of law. But what the court reflects, that is that we people are discussing here, what sort of examination we are carrying out, what sort of techniques we are using, what sort of software we are using. Recently, Mr. Mahendra Verma has put a clear thoughts that even you have a good instruments, but basically the brain behind the machine is naturally required. Similarly, in the case of laws, you may be a good driver, but if you don't have the practice experience of a driver or a swimming or the flyer, you cannot fly. It is like that. I'll give you an encyclopedia, how to fly. I'll give you all the encyclopedia of how to fly and confined to a room. You cannot fly once you don't have the experience to fly. Similarly, in the case of a forensic document expert, as Vijay said, that I emphasize to my experts to present yourself in the court of law. Because this is the opportunity, this is the place wherein your vote is admissible in the court. And what court says under section 293, basically we people are saying that our report is admissible under 293. Sorry to say that, friends, I'll touch the topic which is called technical, because these are basically things which is relevant with the court of law. 293 means it deals with the conviction of admissibility of the report in the court of law. Wherein, in the case of a Keshav Dutt versus the state of Haryana in 2010, the court has given a clear cut judgment, and I quote, that the expert is not a fact. Expert, the opinion of expert is not relying under section 293. He has to come and face in the court. Similar judgment is given in the case of Sunil Kumar, state of Punjab. It is referred by the Supreme Court of India, wherein again they are saying that yes, the expert has to tender his evidence in the court of law. It is not that automatically his report is admissible in 293. And the third court, again the Supreme Court, said in 2008, I think, yes, in the case of a Prakash Kapoor, I think, versus state of Maharashtra, wherein they said that the report of admissibility of the report is not automatically done under 293 CRPC. So this is basically the area wherein you people should equip yourself to present in the court of law. And here you are having, once you are giving report in the laboratories, you are having a 7-star or 10-star facilities. You are having all the things achieving around you, take, retake, and everything you can do. But in the case of a courts, I'm lucky that I tender in every district of India, the courts. It is not that I confined to Delhi. And you have to face the music from the renowned advocates. I'll not put the name of ABC. You can use yourself to see, because the cases in the CBI, the advocates are highly paid. This is what it was quoted by Shri O.P. Saini in the case of the 2G scam, wherein I was tendering my evidence. Friends, it is a lethal on the part of us. The court, which Supreme Court, again, in the case of, I'll call that Ramchandra Agarwal versus Regency's Hotel, says, the expert is not the fact. This is what he said. The expert is not the fact, and his opinion is advisory in nature. So you may talk of so many things that you are doing, but basically, the things which you get the results is the court. The court has said that it is an advisory in nature. Means court can change your opinion also once you're not having experience to attend to your evidences. So a lot of impact is there once you're attending your evidence in the court of law. And this is what he said. This is what the Honorable Supreme Court has said in this case. Friends, conventionally speaking, we are giving reports on the, as it is mentioned in 2020 agreements also, that we are giving report on examination of handwriting, detection of forgery, reconstruction of charred documents, that to some extent, if the document is burned up to 270, 280, nobody can do anything. Then we have a limitation that what sort of examination we can carry out if a document is charred up to 250 degrees centigrade. We don't have an experience. I'm plainly speaking, friends. We don't have an experience if a document is tempered to 90 degrees centigrade, how to present the documents. We are applying the same polyvinylate principle. We should not reduce or increase the concentration of the polyvinylate. So these are the things which we are having a limitation. Otherwise, we are doing the best in our field, like that of instrumental examination of erased writing, obliterated writing examination, then indentation can be done with this, that. These are the things which a routine person can do, even any person, even the lab assistant of my department is doing that. But apart from that, there is a challenge we should reflect. What are the challenges and how we have to tender this evidence in the court of law, friends? The challenges before us is basically to examine the initials. How many persons are giving report on the initials, friends? The challenges before us is how to examine the figures, to give opinion on the digits or figures, if we are having limited of 3-4 digits. The challenges before us to give report on the limited standards. I was unlucky that I didn't, in the case of Ajay Sharma's lecture on the standardization of how to procure the standards and what sort of limitations are required. But definitely, friends, if the standards are limited, people are reluctant to give reports. And there are systems, it is on the mockery of the evidences for judiciary, that we say that please give the speed of the standards, slow, medium and high, the speed cannot work, friends. Once we say that it is a brain-generated document, the speed of exam, speed low, medium and high, can't use for examination of handwriting signatures. So standards are required, the limited standards are required. The Copenhagen has also reflected this in our book in a detailed examination, how to collect the standards and what sort of standards are required. the standards of a contemporary period, it may be better that it should be having a 2 years gap, or it is better to have the same year period because of recently, just Dr. Verma has said that the contemporary period standards are required. So definition of his contemporary period is also very challenging. Then we are having evidence, the limitation to examine the colored photocopy, the origin of the colored photocopy. Friends, recently, science has been developed by a software is developed by the Japan, which is called Bitmap software, which gives the law enforcement agencies, wherein we can say that, yes, this colored photocopying machine has been used for writing or challenging these documents. So these are the challenges. Apart from that, there are so many challenges. Apart from we are doing examination and writing signature, there are so many challenges where we are lagging behind. The other is basically the opinion. You'll surprise to hear it, friends. You'll surprise to hear the opinion on the conventional typewriter was admissible in the court of law. The opinion on the conventional typewriter was not admissible in the court of law. This was an evidence, this was a judgment of some Andhra Pradesh High Court, wherein they said that the opinion on the origin of the typewriter script is not admissible in the court of law. It was in 1955 and it runs throughout the years to 1996. And there was a case which is called a Sikand murder case. The Supreme Court has changed. A constitution bench was constituted of five bench, judges of Supreme Court of India. They said that, yes, henceforth, the opinion on a typescript is admissible in the court of law. What was happened that a parcel bomb was received by some Krishan Sikand. This was the case. You can see here in the net also. He received, it was a script which is typed, the address one. This is Krishan Sikand, something, Sundarnagar, New Delhi. Once he opened it, it was lost and it was spot dead. He was spot dead. Lot of exercise was carried out. Ultimately, we checked the typewriter and connected the typewriter script which was written there. And the matter went to 10 years for CBI to prove it. And luckily or unlucky that, friends, I was the person who was there in this case, assisting my mentor who was happened to be trained by the Yardless. I can't forget his name, that Mr. Shanti Gupta, who was happened to be a father of the question document examination of the world. Father of the question document examination. Still, he's around 90 years old in life. God bless him. So, after 40 years or 50 years of the independence, the opinion of the typescript was admissible in the court of law. This was the exercise which was carried by the forensic document experts. So this, the other tools, like opinion on the initial, opinion on the photocopy, it should also be carried out. And other aspects of the areas, friends, other aspects of the areas, which is also very dangerous now, the opinion on the various types of inks. We are once talking of the inks. Mind it, friends, we are not the FBI. Wherein we are having laboratory samples over there. We are, every Tom and Jerry is making inks after 20 minute kilometers in Delhi or outside Delhi. Every. So we cannot deprive him because this is the bread and butter to them. So only thing is that we have to see the elemental composition, the impurities of the ink that cannot work with the help of the UV and other things. We have to apply the new technologies. We have to apply the new technology. Everybody knows that ink contains the pigments and the vehicle may be ABCD. This is basically the challenges basically. So we should reflect once we are interacting. See, all are very senior officers and we are interacting. We are giving this letter to our generations. So we should know what sort of limitations we are having, friends. The other area, we will talk of these areas. The other area, friends, then we'll discuss how to carry out this. The other area is basically how to examine the electronic ink, which develops recently. What is basically, people don't know what is the electronic ink and how it works. If it is one stock of the electronic, it may be a color or black and white. Then we have to segregate it by this ways. Then we have to examine the conventional method, which we are having a burning issue, like Dr. Verma just said, that age of a ink, then age of a paper, then age of a ABC. The age is basically the burning issue. As Ranjit has just said, that your age is also a burning issue. Never mind, Ranjit, you will also look young after 60 years because your heart is very clear, that no, your brain is also clear than that of your heart. So you will look young. I look young because I eat little, but I enjoy too much. I'm sitting in 5-star facilities in my house, which is full of grain. I used to walk many times. I take a little bit of food, which I am having. Then other topic, friends, that apart from the age, is the colored photocopying machine, which I referred that we are having a software, which is called that. Then the maximum private institutions are receiving the cases, or the CBI is receiving the cases, maximum times. Are the cases which are the reproduced copies of the photocopies. So it was in 2006, I think, I was interacting with my seniors in this organization, where I was heading for the last 20 years, for 15 years. Said, Mr. Hunter, you're not giving report on the photocopies, and we are only getting the documents, that is, after 2 years, 3 years of the cases to be examined and handed over to the organization. And how to meet the end of a justice? So in 2006, friends, say way back, 16 or 15 years, 14 years back, I started giving report on the photocopies. And I'm doing good. No case was disbelieved by any court. And mind it, friends, in India, I made a SOP on the request of the, on the orders of the Home Secretary in 2014. I said that henceforth we should give report on the photocopies because the days are coming. We are having only two types of crimes, friends. One is a digital documents and the other is a hard copies. And once we are not meeting with the end of a justice, we are not meeting with the end of duties which are giving, which the government is paying us. So 2006, I started giving reports, and very few laboratories, I should not put the name, I should put the name of one officer, I feel proud of it. He is in Punjab, nobody knows him, he is Dr. Kalia. He is giving report on the photocopies. Hangulu is also giving report on the things. My lovable Vijay is also giving report on the copies, photocopies, but there are very little persons who are giving report on the photocopies, friends. And definitely the days are coming once we are not giving report on the photocopies. It is always electronically produced document. It is always electronically produced documents wherein you people have to give report on the photocopies. And sorry to say, but it is a very serious note. We'll try to start this topic. Friends, I had interaction with the senior officer sitting in the advisory boards of the Government of India, Ministry of Home Affairs. They said, Mr. Handa, how the quality can be improved? One said, why you are not saying that accreditation can be done? So accreditation means NABL can't work, friends. It is a documentary evidence where you can say that centers are this, take this, humidity chamber, this thing. But only thing is that once you have the experience to tender your evidence in the court of law. And other said, friends, very sorry to say that. Some software has been developed by the IIT Guwahati. They said that 80% of the cases were solved with that software. My clients rest on to 20%. So we require 100%. The other says, have you heard the name of DocBox? What is this? The Hyderabad person has developed a software in which you said you can have your writing of in digital can be set out. Friends, what to say of these fellows? These are making the mockery of the handwriting examination, friends. And one, furthermore, one, what he said that, why can't we make a database of the signatures? Just Mahendra Singh, who is having a 40 years of the experience, friends, 44 years experience. We used to interact many a times. Please call him and say that, please take these samples of his life, say around say 4 lakhs or 5 lakhs samples. Even if we have one person's signature, cannot be categorized. So these types of Mickey and Mouses are there in the setting of the hierarchies. I had a discussion with the senior officers at the joint secretary level. So what sort of persons they are hiring and saying that, yes, we have to increase the conviction rate. You can't in conviction. You can't. Friends, apart from that, these are the burning issues, the photocopies and all the things. There is a one hybrid forgery is one of the factor nowadays. Even I can take the signature of Hashim, my good friend of mine sitting in Iran, and copy it many a times. Even I take the Urdu signatures and even take the Urdu context and make a replica. You will damn here to find, even there's an indentation of the strokes. There is an instrument which make a hyper forgery. I'll publish. There will be a forensic class on that, friends. So these are the areas. These are the areas which one has to be covered. And I'm good that feel good that I was called in this. And please find out the ways on that. I'll come out to one or two solution, one or two things, friends. As just said, that we have done orders which has been implemented by the Supreme Court of India in the case of a handwriting examination with regards to typewriter examination of origin of the typescripts. Friends, I used to interact many a times to many persons. I love to give lectures, even paid, it is better, even not paid, it is far better. And once we are interacting with my local police, I'll give you an example how we are solving the case. Basically, forensics relates to the court of law. And if you are having a conviction in the court of law, you are doing the test. He said, he was basically the SHO of some area, inspector of the area. He said, Mr. Handa, once you are giving the opiates, once you are giving the lectures, your excellence is fabulous. These things you are doing. But once you have come down to the reality, you are big zero. He was basically, he said, any some issues? What is the issue? Yes, sir, I am the SHO of this area, somewhere in north of Delhi. And I have a position of that area, which is called Gujranwala town, somewhere in Delhi. So person one, I'll put the name because there is a person, this is the thing which can be recorded. So there was a person who was owner of this house, which is called Atwal. He was happened to be a Sikh, green shift. He went sick for 6 months to meet his daughter at Canada. So once he was landed in Delhi, he was not allowed to enter in the premises. He was not allowed to enter in the premises by the police. He said that you have sold this property to his tenant, whose name was, I think, Taneja. You sold this property. And what Taneja has done? Taneja has put a litigation, Taneja has put a FIR in the police station that since Atwal was in hurry to go to meet his daughter at Canada, so all the original documents are lying in the with him. He has given me only photocopies of the documents, and these are the photocopies of the copies which I am submitting to the court of the police station. Once he landed in Delhi, he should not be allowed to enter in the premises because he sold his property. No, friends, you people are aware of that. There is a sealed deed, there is which we have 3-4 signatures. There is a power of attorney. It is all over the world, which we have 3-4 signatures. There is a rent receipt. There is a receipt, receipt of the amount, and one or two documents which we have 20, 25, 30 signatures. You can sell everything and anything across world. So these are the 4 sets of signatures. He said that 4 sets of paper bearing 20 by 26 signatures. He sent for his examination to a person, the laboratory. When they received, because no laboratory was giving report on that time, they are not giving report. So they said that we cannot express opinion. We cannot express opinion because these are the photocopies. So said, once I saw that Mr. Handa is giving lecture, I came personally and say that this is my grievances that you people are. Not only this is the grievances, this is the too much grievances because this Atwal has went to the media. And he knocked the doors of the vigilance of the local police. And there is a, what he said, that it is an allegation against me, something is gone against us. So the only thing is that these are little bit issues. Send it this document to me. As a HOD, I can recall the documents. I take permission from my higher-ups in the case of CBI and started doing the cases. I said to my junior, who was happened to be a good friend of mine, he's not basically my junior, I said, Jitin, please start this case and see the exhibits. Well, Handa sir, this is a case to examine. He examined 3 sets of documents, 3 sets of signatures, which superimpose over each other after reducing and enlarging the document. After inducing and enlarging the 3 sets of signatures. And the law of handwriting science says, this is a law which is very useful for us, that no two signature matches with each other because the variations are bound to go. So how much impact is there? 420, 465, 470 section was applied to Taneja and he got his job, he got his place. So these are the things. This is the case still trial. This is the case still trial. Leave this case, friends. Leave this case. I was called in 2012 or 13, my friends, by the Honorable Court of VP Vash. Honorable Court of VP Vash. VP Vash was, since I traveled across India, that's a lot of criminals, a lot of judges, a lot of advocates, we know each other. A lot of persons like Handa know each other. So he called me, Mr. Handa, where are you? I said that I am in the office, please come down to the High Court. So he was there in lower court, we know each other. He was, so you know the hierarchy system in the courts. Person join as a MM, then CM, and then ASA or DJ, then elevated to the higher court as a registrar, not directly to the court, then to the judges, then Supreme Court and extra, all these things. So he called me, I reached there, there were 5 persons sitting. Very interesting case, friends. It's very interesting case. There was a piece of a paper which has happened to be the photocopy of the letterhead of Indian Air Force. Wherein it was written that job number 1 and 2 is allotted to Surinder Kumar. I'm not giving the exact name. For 10 years leave basis or 2 years leave basis. And it was signed by some girl which is called Neha Rana. Flight Lieutenant, Western Command Office, New Delhi. Our Western Command Office is at Subrata Bagh, New Delhi. Air Force has Western Command Office. So this goon, who was happened to be ex-sergeant Surinder Kumar, who took this paper, he said that I have taken this paper from the notice board of the Air Force and went to the High Court. See this modus operandi of this smart fellow. I said that 25,000, the person has lost his life. And 170, 188, 2,000, how many crores of rupees? So a lot of money is involved in that. So he took this paper. He said that he alleged that this paper has been taken out from the notice board of the Air Force. And Air Force has allotted me 2 shops, but they are not giving me the position. So I request the Air Force to give the High Court must order the Air Force to give the position. What is the modus operandi, friends? If you check, 2010 cases are pending in our Air Force courts. Once the matter goes to the regular hearing, it will come after 10 years and the lease is of 10 years. I'll say thank you very much. I'll enjoy for all the 10 years and not even giving to the single. So the issue was that, friends. So now, what is the beauty of the thing is, 5 persons were sitting there once I called that. One is the senior most officer, the air pollution command, the other is the next to them. And third is a lady, which is called Neharana, and she was crying hard. Because she was booked in this case. How you put the signature? She was booked in this case, how to put the signatures. So now she was crying and she is crying hard, sir, I'm a peanut to the society. How dare I can put my signature? These are not my signatures. These may be my signatures, but I have not this. I have not done any mischievous thing. Friends, once you are interacting to the physically of that girl, she was 23, 24, all the career is behind. She may go to the level of group captain or more. But once you are booked, means you are booked. I said, Mr. Hunter, please extract the truth because you are the persons who are, you are a high record of the central forensic labs. Now, what to talk of labs, sir? It depends on the individual, but how you booked it? You should give an inquiry and carry out the things. Friends, the fourth person was also sitting, was the expert from the FSL local. So what Mr. Vash has given, this is fact. Mr. Vash has given an original copy to my best expert, one of the best expert who was happened to be in the local lab, him, and the copy of that copies to me and said that I want your report by tomorrow. Friends, I said that I worked with Dr. Mami, I worked with Dr. Hegel. If some people know that they are the mentors of the forensics in India. So they just taught us that the court is supreme to us. There he has, court has ordered to give the report by next day. So Anurag Sharma, who happened to be the best expert ever produced by this country, one of the best experts ever produced by this country, he submitted his report next day that I cannot express opinion because the technology or the availability of the technology in our laboratory, we cannot express opinion in the photocopies. I said that although it is a photocopy, friends, but chances of lifting of Neha Rana's signature and planting on this document, we don't have the specimens. Chances of lifting of Neha Rana's signature and planting on this document, which is allegedly made, cannot be ruled out. Next day, both submitted their. So VPS said, Mr. Handa, we don't require your reports because this is only report for use for dustbin. He said that we cannot express opinion. You said that chances of lifting. See, court cannot run on the basis of chance. He said the court cannot run basis of a chance. It requires 100% conviction. This is why I said that 293 is not applicable. You require 100% conviction. Either it is in the form of a yes or no. I said, you have said that I know a little bit of English. I said, sir, you said that give report by 15 hours, 20 hours. So the next day we have to submit the report. So give us some time. Instrumental examination require a little bit of time. Okay. I remember, friends, that was Friday. The court has ordered Mr. Handa, today is Friday. Please submit your report by Monday. So only 2 days left. So luckily, friends, I was there in 2 days because hopefully we were visiting. We are flying Delhi, Bombay, Delhi, Calcutta, many times, whichever one knows it well. We enjoyed a lot of things together with my friends sitting in FSL. We enjoyed. We don't take lunch at 1 or 2:30. We just know that. But we enjoy. We work for late hours also. So 2 days I opened my office. It is not that rocket science we are using, friends. It is little bit of a mind we are using and applying themselves. So Swapnil was happened to with me at that time. I remember that Swapnil said that, sir, please see the microscope examination of that signature should be carried out. So we examined. I'll tell you, friends, how to examine these photocopies. We can see the roller marks. We can see the if a document is scanned and other document is a photocopy, the signature contains the scanning marks. If it is a laser, a lot of scans, dots are there. It doesn't require a machine of a crore rupees. Or we can use the panchromatic light. We can use the white mercury light. We can use the tertiary, secondary, and primary filters. I will not give you the detail of that. You can use every different types of filters. You can get the results also. And luckily, friends, because the Air Force use the roller papers, and the roller papers are having a square marks. So only on the concentrated areas, the square marks are there. So I have submitted my 18 points report, squeezing effect, relative alignment, and all these things, that there is a square which is only in the considered area and having a spots. So the signature of Neha Rana is lifted by friends. She was immediately called back to the service. And furthermore, friends, I will tell you, now I went with the report. I said to Mr. Sir, this is the report. Now you feel happy that I have given a report clear cut. But Mr. West has said, Mr. Hunter, there is a problem now. I said, what is this problem again? Can I see, there is a contradiction of two reports. Anurag has given a report that it is a, we cannot express opinion. You said that you, this is a chances of, you said that this part, the signature is lifted. Now, why you called him? No, 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 please. Now, sir, he's a very good expert. He's better expert than me. He thoroughly examined, if you see the second para of his report, he thoroughly examined the document. He said that there is no pen, whole marks and fiber disturbance from the backside. Because you see the statement of that person, he said that I lifted from the notice board of the airports. So when a document is planted or placed in the notice board or any player, there must be a system. Once you pin it or once you tape it, fiber disturbance will be there. Once you pin it, the pinhole must be there. So he said that no pinhole is there, nothing. Fiber disturbance means the document was never in the notice board. The report went to the, it is a system, friends. She was called back to the service by Vaishta. The report went in the full-fledged court, which is called S. Muralidharan. S. Muralidharan Saab has given his landmark judgment, friends. He said, yes, henceforth, the report on the document export, on the photocopies that disabled in the court. You please go and study this assessment. He lauded the judgment, the opinion given by, feel proud of it, by me, that is, Handa is not given report, we cannot meet the end of the justice. And why can't a section 344, the 340 is applied and this fellow must be booked in the local police station. So this is a revert of the report system, wherein the previously the report of on the photocopies, that was a case in 1978, that was a case in 1978, which says, and I'll quote, this is a case of an honorable court of a Ramanathan versus state of Tamil Nadu. This says that report on the photocopy is not admissible. So after say years together, now the report on the photocopy is admissible. There are a lot of cases, friends. There are a lot of cases. There are a lot of citations. I think you can't digest me to have a continued interaction. So I think my time is quite over. So we'll have another topic. We'll have another discussion sometime else. And we'll put we'll definitely put the burning issues. I'm thankful to Ranjit to call me on this platform to interact with my friends. And thankful to Vijay to give me a little bit introduction. It is better to have a physical interaction, but definitely we'll meet sometimes. After 2 years, we will be meeting to avoid this corona. With 1 year, I was in pause, another is definitely will pass, inshallah. Good morning, good afternoon, friends.